Penh ơi bảy năm nực nàng khmien sbai khnong ara khnyom khliet pi nang chot khnyom khlot sa khmang.
This week we've been engaging with questions of memory, reconciliation, and intergenerational dialogue in Cambodia. And we've been focusing on several sites, the first of which been based around the Anlong Veng area in northern Cambodia, which is infamous as the last stronghold of the former Khmer Rouge movement, where Pol Pot died and some of his henchmen, including Tan Mok, were also in residence between already for the last 20 years of the movement's existence.
The significance of Anlong Veng is that the Anlong Veng is the place where almost 80% of the Khmer Rouge members still live here, and they still stick to their own ideologies, mentalities, and livelihoods, so, and ways of life. So that's why Anlong Veng is quite a unique place to reflect the whole genocide of Cambodia. So we need to work with them, and also we try to understand them about why they keep thinking that way. So this is very important that the younger generation need to know both sides, because we cannot discriminate against anyone in our society.
For this week, we joined the group of 12 people of the pedagogical training student to Anlong Veng Peace Center to see the different side of the historical side in the former Khmer Rouge like.
Nhom chong phiap khnie jeung tik tha nei klai ni pi dam lai keu chea pteah pachom bos tamok. Chang pteah pachom ni pi dam lai keu tok ke tok kaki hai ke dak nei klai nu hai Pol Pot chea tu tu kot ankuay nei khang nei hai mem chea kai nu kot ankuay sdap pi lebiab dal.
And this is all in the wake of the experience of democratic Kampuchea between 1975 and 1979, when in Cambodia 1.7 million people died of starvation, execution, or disease. Now, one of the challenges we have in terms of our representations and understandings of the Cambodian experience is that the periodization of democratic Kampuchea to 1975 to 1979 somewhat clips the story. From 1979 to actually 1998, a civil war was raging in Cambodia. And so we've encountered actually this week experiences of people who were mobilized and recruited, conscripted under the Khmer Rouge in periods after the Khmer Rouge genocide. So this complicates our understanding of what it even means to be a perpetrator or a member of a stigmatized community like Khmer Rouge.
មកតាំងដល់5ឆ្នាំ5ឆ្នាំបាទបាទខ្ញុំមកមានការទម្លាក់តម្រូវសួរខ្មែរក្រហមសួរថាតើខ្ញុំអាចទៅឧស្សម័យនេះតំបន់ឧស្សម័យនេះខ្ញុំអាចទៅតំបន់ឧស្សម័យបានអត់ដល់ពេលខ្មែរក្រហមខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងថាគេមានកម្រិតយ៉ាងម៉េចចំពោះខ្ញុំទេគេថាយើងអាចទៅបានតិចតាមរយៈគេមកហើយឡើងទៅជាមួយគេទៅអាចឆ្លងកាត់ឧស្សម័យបានហើយគេសួរដែរគេសួរថាទៅឧស្សម័យទៅអីខ្ញុំថាខ្ញុំចង់ទៅរកពូខ្ញុំ យ៉ាងថាអីទេពួកខ្មែរក៏ហមនឹងហ្វុនដំបិចនៅទីតូងគ្នាអញ្ចឹងគេអាចមកបានដល់ពេលដែលខ្ញុំមកដល់គ្រឹបផែនការប្រែប្រួលខាងហ្វុនដំបិចគេចូលទៅរីរដ្ឋាភិបាលដល់ពេលខ្មែរក៏ហមបានចូលទេអញ្ចឹងខ្ញុំតតបានដល់តតបានខ្ញុំវាជៀបគៀងខ្មែរក៏ហមហើយអញ្ចឹងផែនការទី2ទៀតខ្ញុំប្រុងឡើងទៅថៃចោះចូលទៅថៃដល់ទៅដល់ទៅរូតថៃក៏គៀតឲ្យឆ្លងកាត់ទៀត
Documentation Center of Cambodia, it's called DCCAM. It was established in 1995, and its main objective is to document and research on the history of the Khmer Rouge. We work to promote peace, memory, and reconciliation for our population, and we also try our best to prevent such genocide from happening again in our society.
And one of the things that we need to be respectful of in Cambodia is the fact that memories of genocide are being pulled in different directions.
This place is very popular with Cambodian visitors for picnics.
Yep.
And also for weddings, right?
For yeah, not so much wedding okay, right now. Right. It's mostly picnic. Yeah, like more like a drinking party or something.
Okay, right.
They usually
right.
you know bring food and beer, and also they have their own karaoke, like portable karaoke.
There's
they
a
have
portable karaoke at yeah, the house. Right.
They bring their own from elsewhere. They really? Have this speaker and then there's the microphone.
Is this
where they would just
what kind of special stuff. Occasions? Just
no, just everyday occasions.
Just everyday occasions.
I mean, Anlong Veng people also like to party a lot.
They like to party a lot. Okay.
The focus of our project is intergenerational memory and the way that intergenerational memory and dialogue can support and promote reconciliation. And that's with an appreciation of reconciliation as a contested idea.
Could we ask maybe what does reconciliation mean to him then?
Chúng nó phải đài chúng ao chọn chăm chọn ấy chẳng á na, bên tai tao miền ở vậy đài chia ca sạp xa xem đập bù miền này chẳng mạnh.
Sao vậy mà?
What's been particularly exciting actually for me this week has been an understanding and a stretching of my my appreciation of reconciliation by virtue of the participatory filmmaking methodology. And this is principally because when we've approached and understood reconciliation in Cambodia and the meanings at least that Cambodian communities attach to reconciliation, it's principally been about deterrence. It's principally been concerned with the idea that we must prevent these sorts of atrocities happening ever again. Now actually what we've seen with the engagement of young people in particular through the use of film is a much more empowering set of pro-social engagements that extend beyond that more narrow, deterrent, minimalist understanding of reconciliation.
ខ្ញុំឈ្មោះហនអវីជាគ្រូសិស្សឆ្នាំទី2នៃមជ្ឈមណ្ឌលគ្រូបសាភូមិភាគតាកែវតំណាងឲ្យក្រុមទី3ដែលមានសមាជិកចំនួន4នាក់ជាពិសេសនោះគឺពួកយើងតែ4នាក់បានធ្វើការបတ်សម្ភារធ្វើបတ်សម្ភារទៅលើអ៊ំស្រីចំនួន2រូបបាទអ៊ំអាចជួយបងណូធ្វើកងគីឡាត់គីប្រើអ៊ំតោតាំងយប់អោតោតាំងយប់ប្រើអ៊ំថ្ងៃអ៊ំតោតាំងថ្ងៃមិនអោយលឺម៉ោងគីបានទេទី ខោមងលឺមងគីក៏គីវិញហេចូលអាត្រូនតើយើងណាបោះអង្គុលខាងនេះបោះអង្គុលខាងនេះខាងនោះក៏យកឲ្យជីកដាក់ឲ្យជីកដៃដាក់ក្នុងនោះបើត្រង់គេមើលថាត្រង់ហើយនេះបើមិនត្រង់ទេគេកាយដៃចេញអស់វិញឲ្យឯងបិទសាមក្រោយទៀតដាក់បង្ខំ
ហើយដប់6គូគេហៅឈ្មោះផ្កាផ្កាបើយើងមិនស្លាញ់គ្នាគេយាមវោះព្រឹកថ្ងៃនេះពួកខ្ញុំបានមកធ្វើជាទស្សនកិច្ចសិក្សាមួយដែលសិក្សាអំពីទៅលើរបបខ្មែរក្រហមតើរបបខ្មែរក្រហមនោះវាមានអត្រាយ៉ាងណាចំពោះពី ប្រជាជនកម្ពុជាយើងសពថ្ងៃនេះផងដែរមេក្រហមគេវាយលឹងកាន់កាប់មកអនុបានយ៉ាប់ខ្លាំងហើយនោះបាទសម្លាប់ប្រជាជនក៏បង្អត់ក្រហមកាន់កាប់ណាប្រព័ន្ធជួចជាតិណាឬជួចជាតិឆ្នាំណាបាទជួចជាតិសឹងថានៅមិនបានខ្ញុំទៅស៊ីនៅតាមព្រំដែននេះតើដូច្នេះហើយក្នុងគោលដៅសំខាន់នេះ ខ្ញុំគិតថាពួកខ្ញុំមុននឹងបានមកដល់ទីនេះខ្ញុំគិតថាវាមិនមែនជារឿងពិតកើតឡើងពិតមែនទេដែលហេតុអីថាយើងគ្រាន់តែអានសិភៅយើងបានមកជួបផ្ទាល់តែមកដល់ពេលនេះពួកខ្ញុំបានមកជួបផ្ទាល់ហើយក៏បានធ្វើបទសម្ភាសជាមួយនឹងលោកអ៊ំអ្នកមីងចំនួន2រូបទៀតផងដែរនេះជាភស្តុតាងមួយបញ្ជាក់ថាវាមិនពិតជារឿងកើតឡើងពិតប្រាកដមែននៅក្នុងរបបនេះហើយខ្ញុំនឹងយកចំណេះដឹងនេះ
I really like this program. I have no experience before, and then I came here, and then you teach me to use the camera video, and I'm so excited to do that. It's the first time for me that I come here, learning like how to use camera, make a video, and I have make a conversation with a villager in this, and I have known so many things about Khmer Rouge, and it's the real thing and the real place that I have known.
I think the student have done a really good interview and received a good collaboration with the local resident, because I expect that they might be afraid of talking in camera, but as I can see from since the morning until now, the local residents seem to be very happy and seem to be feel empowered to talk on camera and record. So hopefully their story can be a really meaningful tool that inspire others to talk.
ប្រវត្តិល្បីល្បាញក្នុងលោកដែរប្រលឹងជាតិខ្មែរឋិតថេរគង់វង្សជ្រោកក្រោមលុបទុងប្រាសាទអង្គរ